साई राम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ जीके। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर न्यू लेसन, लेसन नंबर 13, स्पेस ट्रैवल। नाउ लेट अस सी क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन। आंसर द फॉलोइंग। इन विच ईयर द स्पेस स्टेशन स्काईलैब वॉज लॉन्च बाय द यूएस? आंसर इज 1973। Skylab was the first United States space station launched by NASA, occupied for about 24 weeks between May 1973 and February 1974. It was operated by three separate astronaut crews, SL2, S3 and SL4. Major operations included an orbital workshop, a solar observatory, Earth observation and hundreds of experiments. Next question. In which year India launched its first satellite, Aryabhatta? Answer is 1975. Aryabhatta was India's first satellite, named after the famous Indian astronomer. It was launched on 19th April 1975 from Kapustinia, a Russian rocket launch and development site in Astrakhan Oblast, using a Cosmos 3M launch vehicle. It was built by the ISRO. Next question. Which was the first US satellite? Answer is Explorer 1. Explorer 1 was launched on January 31st, 1958 at 10:48 p.m. Eastern Time, atop the first Juno booster from LC-26 at the Cape Canaveral Missile Annex in Florida. It was the first spacecraft to direct the Van Allen radiation belt, returning data until its batteries were exhausted after nearly 4 months. It remained in orbit until 1970 and was followed by more than 90 scientific spacecraft in the Explorer series. Next question. Which spacecraft carried the dog Laika into space? Answer is Sputnik 2. Laika, a stray mongrel from the streets of Moscow, was selected to be the occupant of the Soviet spacecraft Sputnik 2 that was launched into outer space on 3rd November. In which year did Valentina Tereshkova go into space? Answer is 1963. Valentina is a member of Russia State Duma, engineer and former cosmonaut. She is the first and youngest woman to have flown in space with a solo mission on the Vostok 6 on 16 June 1963. She orbited the Earth 48 times, spent almost 3 days in space, and remains the only woman to have been on a solo space mission. Next question. Who was the first American to orbit the Earth? Answer is John Glenn. John Glenn was a United States Marine Corps aviator, engineer, astronaut, businessman, and politician. He was the first American to orbit the Earth, circling it 3 times in 1962. In which year did the US launch Telstar, the first communication satellite? Answer is 1962. The first two Telstar satellites were experimental and nearly identical. Telstar 1 launched on top of Thor Delta rocket on July 10, 1962. It successfully relayed through space the first television pictures, telephone calls, and telegraph images, and provided the first live transatlantic television feed. Telstar 2 launched May 7, 1963. Telstar 1 and 2, though no longer functional, still orbit the Earth. Next question. What is the name of the spacecraft launched in 1989 to study the gravity over Venus surface? Answer is Magellan. The Magellan spacecraft, also referred to as the Venus Radar Mapper, was a 1,035 kilogram robotic space probe launched by NASA of the United States on May 4, 1989, to map the surface of Venus by using synthetic aperture radar and to measure the planetary gravitational field. Next question. Who was the first Indian woman to go into space on NASA shuttle Columbia? Answer is Kalpana Chawla. Kalpana Chawla was an American astronaut, engineer, and the first woman of Indian origin to go to space. She first flew on Space Shuttle Columbia in 1997 as a mission specialist and primary robotic arm operator. In 2003, Chawla was one of the seven crew members who died in the Space Shuttle Columbia disaster when the spacecraft disintegrated during its re-entry into the Earth's atmosphere. Next question. In which spaceship did Rakesh Sharma go into space? Answer is Soyuz T-11. Wing Commander Rakesh Sharma AC is a former Indian Air Force pilot who flew abroad Soyuz T-11 on 3rd April 1984 with the Inter-Cosmos program. Next question. Which country sent first man into space? Answer is USSR, Union of Soviet Socialist Republic. Yuri Gagarin was a Soviet Air Force pilot and cosmonaut who became the first human to journey into outer space, achieving a major milestone in the space race. His capsule, Vostok 1, completed one orbit of Earth on 12th April 1961. Next question. The first man to land on Moon was Armstrong. Second was his colleague Edwin Aldrin. Who was the third person with them? Answer is Michael Collins. Michael Collins is an American astronaut who flew the Apollo 11 Command Module Columbia around the moon while his crewmates Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin made the first crewed landing on the surface. He was a test pilot and Major General in the US Air Force Reserves. Fun fact, the Jupiter could swallow up over 1,000 Earths. Its diameter is 1,42,800 km. One of its moon, Ganymede, is the largest moon in the solar system, bigger than Mercury. Now, let us start our new lesson, lesson number 14, Let's Tour. These are some of the places of tourist interest. Write the name of the cities and countries where they are situated. It was a gift of France to the United States. It is called the Statue of Liberty. Answer is New York, USA. The copper statue, a gift from the people of France to the people of United States, was designed by French sculptor Frederick Auguste Bartholdi, and its metal framework was built by Gustave Eiffel. The statue was dedicated on October 28, 1886. Next question. It is the Notre Dame Cathedral. It was built in 1163 AD. It has a very beautiful stained glass windows. Answer is Paris, France. The cathedral was consecrated to the Virgin Mary and considered to be one of the finest examples of French Gothic architecture. Its pioneering use of the rib vault and flying buttress, its enormous and colorful rose windows, as well as the naturalism and abundance of the sculpture decoration set it apart from the earlier Romanesque style. Next question. It is the Leaning Tower. It is considered one of the wonders of the world. Answer, Pisa, Italy. It is a bell tower. It is famous because it is not vertical. The height of the tower is about 56 meters from the ground. Its weight is about 40,500 tons. It now leans at about 3.99 degrees. The tower has 294 steps. Next question. It is the Wailing Wall. It is the place of Jewish pilgrimage. It is the remains of the great temple built by Herod, king of the Judea, in 1st century BC. Answer is Jerusalem, Israel. It is an ancient limestone wall in the old city of Jerusalem. It is a relatively small segment of a far longer ancient retaining wall, known also in its entirety as the Western Wall. Next question. It is known as the Eiffel Tower. It is a marvelous structure made of wrought iron. Answer is Paris, France. It is a wrought iron lattice tower on the Champ de Mars in Paris, France. It is named after the engineer Gustave Eiffel, whose company designed and built the tower. The tower is 324 meters tall, about the same height as an 81-storied building, and the tallest structure in Paris. Its base is square, measuring 125 meters on each side. Next question. It is the Sphinx. It is a stone sculpture with human head and a lion's body. Answer is Giza, Egypt. It is facing directly from west to east. It stands on the Giza Plateau on the west bank of the Nile in Giza, Egypt. The face of Sphinx is generally believed to represent the Pharaoh Khafre. It measures 73 meters long from paw to tail, 20 meters high from the base on the top of the head, and 19 meters wide as its rear haunches. Next question. It is a huge statue of Christ. It watches over the city from hilltop. Answer is Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Constructed between 1922 and 1931, the statue is 30 meters high, excluding its 8-meter pedestal. The arm stretches 28 meters wide. The statue weighs 635 metric tons and is located at the peak of the 700-meter Corcovado mountain in Tijuca Forest National Park, overlooking the city of Rio de Janeiro. The Buckingham Palace was bought by George III in 1762. It was rebuilt and renovated by John Nash in 1825. Answer is Westminster, London. It is the London residence and administrative headquarters of the monarch of United Kingdom, located in the city of Westminster. The palace is often at the center of state occasions and royal hospitality. It has been a focal point for the British people at times of national rejoicing and mourning. Next question. It is the world's most famous opera house. This famous structure was opened in 1973. It is a landmark structure of the place. Answer is Sydney, Australia. The Sydney Opera House is a multi-venue perform in Arts Centre at Sydney, designed by Danish architect John Woodson, but completed by an Australian architecture team headed up by Peter Hall. The building was formally opened on 20th October 1973. Fun fact, Tower Bridge across the Thames River in London is a movable bridge. The two halves of its roadway are raised for passing tall ships. Now students, we will meet next session. Till then, goodbye. Have a nice day.